Ni slide saya lah. Okey, slide ni kan yang saya bagi dalam bentuk video tu kan? Kelas? Oh, kelas. Kelas, slide ni yang saya tengok dalam bentuk video, right? Okey. So, kelas ya. Macam mana? Boleh tak? Faham tak soalan? Subsequent measurement, slow most of the time macam land. Yeah? The example of PPE, we still are discussing on 116, ya. Yeah? Then how to remeasure. Maksudnya dia ada, do we need to state what amount from the original amount or the book value dan kita ada using our normal practices. Yeah? So do we have to change the value, remeasure. So most of the time we are going to face with the two models. Kan kita ada cost model. Cost model ni kita tak pedulilah apakah dia fair value. We go straight to the we just stick to the cost kan to get the apa ni kita panggil to get the the book value. Dan kita ada revaluation model. Revaluation model kita biasalah kita yang ni kita akan ambil fair value. Yang ni lebih relevant sebab our account will show the true value of the asset. Alright, so kita panggil revaluation model ya. Yeah? Okay, so revaluation model ni sama fair value ni sama-sama is about the selling price lah. How much actually the buyer willing to pay for our goods or for our asset. So depend on demand and supply. Alright, so kita ada revaluation model ni macam mana ya? Kita ada the example lah. Yeah, so but you have to look at the type of asset. Yeah, depend on the whether asset is non-depreciable ke depreciable. Ada asset yang ada depreciate value lain sikit dia punya revaluation model incorporation dia. Yang depreciable asset dia lain sikit. Yeah. So ni yang non-depreciable. So yang ni adalah untuk yang depreciable asset. Yeah. Dia punya treatment ataupun the process of revaluation will have a different treatment. Alright, so ni kita ada ni untuk non-depreciable. Simple ya kelas non-depreciable asset. Once we incorporating the fair value definitely lah kita akan ada two situation deficit and surplus ya, depend on the differences of between the carrying value and fair value. Alright, so kalau surplus simple ya kelas, just debit land. Debit the asset, credit the ARR for non-depreciable asset. Yeah, but that is the exceptional case ya. For surplus yes, we have to debit land, but we cannot certain situation we cannot credit ARR because if those asset had been revalued previously and there is deficit, so we can compensate balik deficit tu. So kita akan credit retain profits, but deficit actually dia akan jadi expenses for the year. Alright, so yeah, ini kalau situation of deficit. Okay, the example why deficit happens. So I show you the Highland Towers, the flood in Temerloh and also the old land in all days in Kuala Lipis, yeah. So value drops but they are no longer useful or give more much benefit due to the disaster. Alright, so here for the depreciable asset, yeah, class. If no for the no non depreciable asset, yeah, land tu. Kalau deficit, dia akan jadi expenses for the year lah. Sakit lah company kalau ada deficit, yeah. But this also there is some exceptional case. For decrease in land, we have to credit land, we have to debit expenses in the name of deficit charge to your profit or loss, except that land was previously having surplus on revaluation. So kita tengok apa-apa tengok zaman dulu kelas, apa-apa tengok previous story. So that's why most of the time I emphasize on timeline. So you can have a postmortem, you can have a clear picture throughout what happened to the asset throughout the year. That's why I think the importance of timeline. Yeah, so you won't lose your track. Okay, so here there's an example. Example is simple. Kan? You have the two land. So the first land on Senawan deficit. So you have to charge deficit by 200,000 because of 600 reduced to 5.8 million. Kan? And then untuk Seremban, there is a surplus. So it's simply surplus, debit line credit ARR, the amount of surplus. But then on Senawang, there is a surplus as well. There is surplus back. So 2009 tu dia deficit, tiba-tiba 2018 dia naik balik kat Senawang. So you have to set off balik apa yang you buat. Last time kita charge deficit 200, now kita count composite balik. So because that one is expenses few years back, 10 years ago, so the value actually retained in the return profit, so charge the to the return profit. So credit return profit to set off back what we did. And then it's only 200k, but we need 300, so the extra of 100 will be goes to ARR. So this ARR is known also as will be recorded as well in your profit or loss statement actually as other comprehensive income. I'll show you afterwards, yeah. And then for the seremban, there's a deficit which is previously surplus, so you have to just write off using composite back there ARR that previously you have, yeah. Okay, so this is for depreciable asset. So depreciable asset, you have to careful. We are again going to face a surplus and deficit. But you have to look at the date. So whether it's beginning, the revision take place beginning of the year, during the year or end of the year. So saya bagi example ini adalah beginning of the year. And then with the surplus situation, because surplus ni yang dia agak complicated. Kalau deficit simple aja, so we are going to have that one also as an example afterwards. Eh? And then this is kata kita value. So again, you look at the timeline over there. So this is an example with the 3 years useful life, definitely. So you have to look at through all the year that goes by, with regard the asset when you consume the asset. Yeah? So we have plenty of them. Okay, saya pergi laju je sebab dah ada dalam video. So first saya tanya, ada soalan tak yang you want to ask regarding with this slide? Because this slide quite a lot of story to tell actually. Anyone? Any question with the slide last? Terjelek hari dah. Tak ada? Tak ada, tak apalah. Okay. So this one I introduce you, Ida. Yeah, so EIDA is when you have to follow the procedure or the process for the surplus of asset. Yeah, because of the depreciable asset, you have to write off everything with the old depreciation. So that's what we meant by eliminating. You have to eliminate because it's no longer relevant. Yeah, so we having a new value. So anything old value, anything related to the old value, for example, accumulated depreciation, write them off. So how to write them off? Eliminate. So eliminate if accumulated deposit is credit, so you have to debit. So elimination normally you have to debit. So you have to eliminate against the asset itself. So it's going to credit the asset 2 million. And then from E, you have I. I is incorporating. So now you incorporate the value. Because you write off, actually you are reducing or you write down the value from cost. This one, pilari blah, mamat tu. Yeah. So you have to write down the asset from higher value to the from the cost value to the carrying value. So from there you are going to compare carrying value and the fair value. So you incorporate the fair value for the sake of surplus. You are going to write up back your asset because of revaluation. So you have to debit back your asset. Alright. So here you have EIDA. So that is you have to depreciate with the new value. So depreciation is with the new value, then with the remaining useful life to find out the new depreciation. But then because of surplus, actually you increase the value of asset. But normally you also increase the depreciation because depreciation based on the asset. The increment is not good for the performance of company because it's going to impact greatly on the profit. So accounting principle allow you to do amortization method where actually the ARR increase, you have to recognize as your revenue for the year. This in order to set off back the higher depreciation just now. The principle allow you to do that. So your profit won't be affected. So you have two choices whether to take up as the cost model or the revaluation model. Either way, it doesn't going to affect your profit. So therefore, your tax remain unchanged. All right. Okay. So next you have amortization. This is one of the principle. Yeah, most of the time, the principle is to help the survival of the company. Yeah, and then this is remote. So next we go for depreciable asset. This is an example of depreciable asset. Okay, so depreciable asset ni kita tengoklah dia punya you have to find the new the depreciation from original value. From there you have to calculate how much it accumulated, then you have revalue Yeah, so the you are going to record at the end of the year after revaluation, take the revaluation value, and then the accumulated depreciation for the first year. So this is the how actually the journal take place during the revaluation should be. Okay. So next you have I'm giving the example of what happened during the year for the financial report. So dah habis. Oh, ni apa pula ni kelas? Oh, this is an example of initial no, this is subsequent cost, yeah, because we haven't discussed this one, so we include as well as part of the exercise, yeah. And then dah habis, yeah. What is this? Dah habis. Oh, this is what happened to the cost. So you can see the video lah. So I'm just asking you if you have a problem to be clarified, because you just watched the video, we don't have any interactive, so I'm giving you chances. Anyone, do you have any question regarding to any slide, any explanation that you want me to go over again? Anyone? Anyone? Class? Ah. Clear, Faris, are you clear with our topic? Because revaluation is very challenging actually, revaluation model. And Fatin Nukwa Marina. Iman Aisyah, Iman Aisyah, where is the question, Iman Aisyah? Misha Amira, are you clear? Misha Amira? Khadijah, you smart ke tak Khadijah? Khadijah, you asam lagi Khadijah? Hari tu kalau buat kat kelas yang buat topi-topi suka, susah Khadijah akan tarik muka dia, kesian pula saya tengok. Khadijah, boleh ya? You smile lagi tengah stres tu Khadijah. Khadijah tak dengar, Khadijah, are you there? Oh, ni pelek ni. Khadijah, you tengah smile ke? You tengah stres tu? Khadijah?
Smile,
smile. Smile tu maknanya clear lah tu. You tak ada masalah? Okay. Okay. So class, any soalan? Oh, Rosalia? Rosalia? What you think, Rosalia?
Okay, madam. Faham je.
Faham? Wow. Very good, eh? So most of the time I will recommend you, strongly recommend it, class, strongly recommend you to have the timeline, so you won't miss any extra information or hidden information from the case study, yeah? Okay lah, penat dah tanya, seram pun tak nak jawab, dah lah kita ni 1 hour je. Alright, so now class, eh, kita buat soalan lain lah. So kita nak tengok betul ke faham. So we practice on other question, boleh?
Boleh.
Okay, do you boleh any juga. Any other preference question on the subsequent measurement? Any other preference question, class? Soalan mana you nak?
December 19.
December 19. Apa benda ni, kejap-kejap. Kenapa tadi keluar je? Eh, macam mana saya nak keluar? Okey ni ha. Haa, dia keluar. Disember ke saya dah ada ni? Ini ke soalan dia? Di June 19. June 19 dah siap ke? Haa, kelas? Oh, June 19 dah yang tadi dah kan? Haa, June 19 dah. Okay, kita tengok soalan bila? December 19. Ni, session 2 ni. Tahun 19 kan? Okay, kita tengok. Hai. Apa tak kawan pula? Oh, ni mesti sebab saya ni yang lama punya dah. Local host. Ha. Rizwan, kenapa you on and off, Rizwan? Kenapa you on and off?
Kena ada dalam video ke?
Eh, December 19 dah ada dalam video eh?
Hmm.
Ambil lah yang belum ada sebab dalam video tu. Unless you're having problem, you want to ask question. Saya rasa December 19 tu yang saya buat timeline huhara dengan line dengan machine ke kan? Is it?
Ya, yeah, madam.
So you please
choose. Madam, December 19 tu. Madam, December 19 tu madam kira untuk C untuk apa subsequent cost. Madam
tak. Oh, subsequent cost je. Subsequent measurement belum? Saksi konfirmasi belum?
Madam suruh, madam suruh buat tapi madam tak suruh bincang. Eh, madam belum bincang.
Oh, kita belum bincang lah. So, did you complete the exercise? Class? December 19 eh?
Yes.
Okay, December 19. So, kita pergi December 19. So, you all complete the exercise tu? Buat tak? Class? Haa ni eh? Disember ke Jun? Tak ada Jun December 19 kelas. Jun 19 dah tak?
Jun 19 dah buat dah je.
Ada Disember?
December 19 dia suruh buat accounting treatment.
Mana Disember? Yang 2020 ke? Ni ya? Agak ah kejap ya cerita ni. Yang ni ke? Ni, December 19. Ni. Alright, so yang mana? Kita dah buat D ya, Dogo. Dalam video tu dah buat D eh. So kita buat C je. Dan video tu C je eh.
Kita buat C je, D belum. Oh.
D belum. Oh, D ni lah yang very challenging. So, you sempat tak buat ni?
Tak.
Apa yang perbuat? Kelas?
Jom buat sama-sama tu.
Ambil. Buat sama-sama. Macam saya seorang je buat tu nanti. Okay, tak apa. Alright, so now. Okay, tengok soalan D kelas. Is the D, once we have the question, very simple lah kelas. Dia beritahu kita ada line, kita ada machine. And then dia kita ada few years back, so it starting with the 2015, 16, ada up to 18. The question ask you to prepare the 16, 18. So you know the duration of the year on the movement of the asset, what happened to the assets from 15 until 18. So now, you have two assets. What should we do first? Anyone?
Timeline.
Yes, we strongly recommend you to do the timeline. So siapa nak take over buat timeline ni? Saya bagi word lah, kita buat dalam word. Siapa nak buat timeline? Anyone? Boleh take over macam mana timeline kita? Saya bagi word ha. Siapa nak buat timeline kelas? Cepatlah. Itulah nak buat sama-sama. Saya seorang je lah pula tu. Mana cik you all?
Tak, saya tak boleh nak conteng lah ni tu.
Oh log, iya ke?
Dekat laptop saya tak keluar dia punya yang tu. Dia kena buka kat phone kalau nak conteng.
Oh, habis apa yang boleh conteng ni?
Yang dah install.
Oh, dia ikut apps ke?
Ramai buka guna browser, madam.
Oh, no wonder lah. Saya pun tak kerti jugalah benda-benda gitu. Okay, kelas ya. Kita ada dua aset dah. So it's strongly recommended. Boleh tak kita buat ni apa ni? Macam mana saya nak buat dia view ke apa? Saya tak nak dia horizontal ni. Kita panggil apa? This is vertical. Saya nak horizontal. Kat mana saya nak buat eh? View eh? Saya nak dia horizontal. Saya tak nak dia vertical. Mana yang kelas? We got it? Ni print. Read more, print. Oh, print layout. Print layout. Ah, tu? Tak ada pun tak boleh apa pun. Macam ni, ni. Ni tulis vertikal tak? Ni side to side apa benda? Side to side. Try. Apa benda ni macam ni? Ini kecil. Ni vertikal dia besar. Macam mana saya nak jadikan dia ni? Sebab saya perlukan besar. Ada cadangan. Apa ya? Pergi mana? Pilihan pula.
Tu madam pergi di layout tu dekat atas. Kolom atas tu pergi layout. Dekat atas sebelah design ni.
Atas pada design ni design?
Sebelah design. Sebelah design.
Oh layout ni.
Ada.
Lepas tu ni.
Orientation.
Lepas tu pakai landscape. Oh thank you Farid. Lecturer tua awak ni buta sikit benda-benda gini. Ha, okay. So class ya, yeah? We have two assets, right? Okey, kita ambil. Kita ada dua aset kan? Haa. Ya, kita ambil dua aset mana pula tadi? Saya nak minima yang ni. Ah, ni dia soalan dia. Ni kenapa soalan dia macam ni? Okey. Macam mana saya nak jadikan dia ni kena... Macam mana saya nak kecilkan dia? Aduh, apa ni? Kecil this one macam saya nak boleh saya bagi dua-dua window sekali tak boleh?
Tu tekan sebelah pangkar.
Sebelah pangkar?
Tekan tu.
Tekan ni?
Tak, yang dekat sebelah tu.
Sebelah yang ni?
Haa, yang tu.
Thank you.
Dia boleh setting lah, ikut Amir dia nak yang tu besar mana sebelah tu besar.
Baik Faris, thank you Faris. Okay, so la ilah benda ni. Okay, come kita tengok soalan ya. So the soalan is about, mana soalan dia? Haa, dia bagi kita nak ringkat-ringkat lah, hempek-hempek sini. Haa, okay macam ni sikit. Okay kelas. Okay, the question tell you about Dogo. Piece of land and machine. So maksudnya kita ada dua aset, right? Kita ada dua aset betul tak? So macam ni kita buat dengan dua aset, I recommend you to have two timeline. So kita buat timeline satu untuk siapa? Kelas?
Land.
Kita buat untuk land. So land ni dia kan warna land, kita bagi ni land, you warna ni. Okay. Next. Kita ada satu lagi, insert lagi. Oh, kali ni tak payah lah. Insert saya boleh copy je kan. Saya copy. Insert saya buat kat sini. Okay, buat dia. Saya pastekan dia. Ada dua kat sini. Right. So, ini adalah untuk mesin. Okay. Mesin nak warna apa? Acah.
Biru.
Warna biru. Orang suka biru Mana pula saya nak masuk ke warna ni kelas? Mana? Kan kita klik kat sini, dia akan keluar warna untuk kita. Oh, okay, cantik. So, kita guna warna biru seperti yang dia minta. Pandai anda buat dua line yang luruh ya. Okay, now, aset ni berkenaan aset mana? Which aset we talking about? Kelas? Aset mana? Apa nama aset dia? Apa nama aset? Aset dia ialah?
Land.
Okay. So, we have land here. Okay, land. Next, kita ada siapa?
Machine.
Okay, so here machine. Alright, so that's for land and machine. Next. Apa lagi yang kita ada seterusnya kelas? We have to do what? Kita kena tahu apa kelas? Kita buat
date.
Yeah. So date ni kita buat, okay, this is tahun bila kita kelas?
2015.
First year katalah this is end of the year 2015 boleh? End of the year 2015. Kita letak warna kuning sikit. Saya suka sikit. Saya suka kuning kot. Alright, so saya kena copy. Saya pilih. Alright. So berapa tahun tu? This is end of year 15. This is end of year 16. This is end of year 16, end of year 17. This is end of year? Apa lah? 18. Boleh? So this is the beginning of the year for the land. So kita akan masuk tahun. Insert kita nak year. Alright, so kita masuk. Okay, ni tahun. Ni. Berapa bulan? Beginning of the year. 31st, December.
December 2015.
Yeah? 2015. So this is on the beginning of the year. Okay. So saya copy je. Saya paste. Dapat banyak. Ini nanti saya susun tahun dia, tukar je tahun dia. Okay, sini tahun. You dia main macam apa kita panggil? Waktu saya tunjuk kat sini-sini you all cara kita main warna buat macam ni. Ya Allah, buang masa dia tu kan. Kalau you cakap, tak apa. Boleh tinggal je macam ni. Okay. So ini kita 15. So sekarang kita cakap this is 16. This is apa kelas?
17.
17 and this is
18.
Good. Okay ni. Kita ambil tengah-tengah tahun.
Yeah, the same thing goes for the machine kan? You're talking about the same, right? Eh, kena pula tahun yang keluar. Nak, kena tahun. Saya nak yang ni sebenarnya. Okay, tak boleh dah. Okay, kita copy. Kita, ya Allah. Tengok tu you all. Mana saya nak buat ni? Cuba saya escape dulu. Okay. Oh, sebab saya kena pinjat sini juga kot. Copy. Satu. Dua. Tiga. Empat. Lima. Alright, so ni saya nak jatuh sini. Ha. Dia titik untuk mesin. Yeah. Tak apa. Ini sebut mesin. Terlebih ni. Ni early. Alright. Okay, so seterusnya apa lagi? Berapa nilai land pada Januari 15? Apa nilai land?
2 million.
So, kita letak so, sini land at this hour is land is
2 million.
Yes, 2 million. And then machine berapa?
500,000.
500,000. Okay. Oh, dah ilang. Oh, ambil. Dah saya buat ni. Okay. Saya save. Alright. Ini. Berapa? 500,000. The machine. Angklan? 500,000. Land and machine 500,000. So apa lagi dia cakap? The estimated useful life of the machine. Estimated useful life of the machine is?
10 years.
It's 10 years. So kat sini ke lah. Estimated useful life. So kita kata okay. Ya, yeah, masukkan. Saya suka buat garis panjang. Ya, yeah, mana garis panjang saya dekat sini. Dalam dia ni. Apa yang ni? Apa yang ni? Sama je ni. Okay, saya so buat macam ni. Alright. Dia 10 years kan? So starting dari sini. Sebelah dia. Bawa panjang ke sama bila-bila lah teknik macam tu. Ini sekolah untuk machine right? So ni macam mana-mana hitam ke? So okay. Kalau you sekolah 10 years berapa kelas? Apa maklumat yang kita boleh dapat? What is the information that we can get?
Depreciation.
Yes, exactly. And you can get the depreciation. Okay, depreciation how much for the machine glass?
Every year 50.
Every year kita akan?
50,000.
Yeah, they akan reduce by 50,000 kan? So this one they gone by 15,000. So depreciation, kita negative dia 50,000. Mana dapat 50,000 tu glass?
500. Divide by useful life.
500 divided by useful life, which is 500 divided by 10 years. Yeah? So every year we are going to depreciate by berapa kelas? 50,000. Kita copy, kita paste kat sini. Okay. So tahun the next year, tahun 60 kelas, depreciate tak? 15,000 lagi. 50,000 lagi kelas. Ada depreciation tak? Ada tak ni kelas? Okay, so now apa cerita kelas? Dia kata reversion is to be done every 2 years. Maksudnya dah genap 2 years kita akan revalue the asset. And then reversion, the disinformation on the reversion of Dogo Berhad. So land on 31 December is 1.9 million kelas. 31 December year 16. Bila kelas? 31 December year 16. Nah, kelas? Bila? Kat mana date dia? So kat sini. Tetapi Rizal bukan kat sini ke kelas? Kat sini.
Yeah. Ya. Ya kat situ.
So kita letak warna merah sikit. Mana merah? Kenapa tak ada warna dah? Warna merah ha kelas? Time. Tak ada dah kot. Oh. Mana saya dapat warna merah ya om? Biru lah pula. Tak ada. Apa dia hari sajalah ha buat macam ni ha ambil hijau ni sikit eh. So ini apa dia kelas? Ini kita apa berlaku pada tarikh ni?
Revaluation.
Revaluation.
Yes, revaluation take place kat sini kan. So, ambil date ni, you kata berlaku revaluation. So, bila revaluation, alright, so di sini kita ada fair value, right? So, revaluation untuk fair value of land, how much? Berapa revaluation untuk fair value of land, class? Class? Berapa?
1.9 million.
Yes, dia dah bagi dah 1.9 million. Good. Okay. So, whereas revaluation untuk, okay, saya copy kat sini pula. Revaluation untuk mesin, berapa pula ni lah mesin? Pada tarikh ini. 450,000. Yeah. So, 450,000. Alright. So, here we have land revalued at 1.9 million. Yeah. We have machine which depreciate with 500 and depreciation take place for 2 years and revalued back to fair value of 450. Clear tak, class? Clear tak cerita ni?
Clear.
Clear.
So now we go to the machine, we go to the 2018. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Sebelum tu, class, kalau you all tengok kat sini kan. Apa yang berlaku pada land? Apa yang berlaku pada land? What happened?
Deficit.
2 million kepada 1.9 million, apa yang berlaku?
Deficit.
Yes, a deficit. So, how is the depreciation take place on this date? Macam mana depreciate dia, dia punya double entry kita kelas? Bila kita nak buat ni. Macam mana? Debit apa? Debit apa? Anyone? Debit apa kelas? Cepat, cepat, cepat. Debit apa?
Debit depreciation.
Debit depreciation? Debit apa? Ah, debit deficit. Deficit ni kita akan charge dalam SOPOS bagi expenses for the year. Spool pula jadinya. So pool. Okay, dan kredit apa? Berapa kita nak debit deficit? Berapa? 100,000. Good. Okay, so next. Kita akan kredit apa?
Land.
Land. Yes. Kita akan kredit land. Okay. So kredit land how much? Sama lah kan? Kredit lah 100K. Okay dah habis. So land is reduced. Mana tadi saya nak home. Terabuk lah benda ni. Kat sini saya nak lihat space tak ya? Ada space. Okay. So this is what happened, right? Kan? So now kita pergi pula dekat machine. How is the transaction take place, class? You kena show apa benda, macam mana double entry kita. So revaluation take place kita letak kat sini. Atas ni. Class, berapa depreciation kita? What is the, apa tu? What will be the double entry to take place on the date of revaluation? Oh, the 31 December year 16, class. Apa dah ambil entry kita? So, class. Debit apa, kredit apa? Debit apa? What happened, class? Ingat tak apa yang kita kena practice ataupun kita kena apply kat sini?
EIDA.
Yes, EIDA. Okay, what is EIDA, the first one? What's it?
Eliminate.
Eliminate is debit what?
Debit accumulated depreciation. Accumulated
depreciation. How much?
50,000.
You can see clearly, right? So next,
yes.
What do we have? Credit what?
Credit machine.
Yes, credit a write-off against the machine itself, right? How much?
100,000
sama. So this actually giving the meaning you are writing down back your asset from the cost to the carrying value. Alright, saya pergi home tadi. Saya nak remove dia space. Dapat saya jamah space. Okay, next. Class, apa lagi? Itu E baru.
I incorporating.
I incorporate. So, how do we incorporate? What is the double entry should take place? Debit what?
Debit machine.
Yes, you have to debit machine. Kenapa you debit machine? By how much? So, actually, you have to compare. You have to determine whether this is surplus or deficit. Surplus ke deficit ni, class? Surplus ke deficit? Revaluation kita adalah fair value dia 450,000, right? You have to compare in order to ensure whether this is a deficit or surplus, you have to compare the value of what, class? The value of fair value dengan carrying value, kan? Kan? Ha, so carrying value kat sini tarikh dia berapa kelas? Berapa jumlah dia? Carrying value kat sini. Yeah, sure 400. Okay, good. Sekejap. Pergi balik pada home. Okay, saya nak. Alright, okay. So carrying value pada tarikh ni berapa? You all. Berapa carrying value of the asset at this date? On the 31st tu? Berapa carrying value? Mana kita nak cari carrying value? Saya dengar tadi jawapan dia betul lah tu. Siapa carrying value dia?
400.
400 kan? Mana dapat 400k?
500.
Yes, you take this 400, you minus the depreciation 50-50, right? So, this is your carrying value. So, from there, you are going to determine you get surplus or deficit. So, what is the situation? Surplus or deficit?
Surplus.
Yeah, surplus by how much?
50,000.
So, if this surplus, debit or credit machine? Debit machine by how much?
Debit machine 50,000.
That's very good. Next, the credit what?
ARR.
Yes, kita kena
ARR.
Yes, ARR. Ya, yeah, ke ARR boleh, betul. And surplus ARR kalau last year tak ada surplus, ya. Yeah? Okay, so ini yang berlaku kan? 50,000. Okay, good. Next. Apa lagi yang kita boleh buat? Apa lagi? Ini baru E dah.
D.
D. Okay, D macam mana kelas? D apa kita kena buat D?
Debit depreciation.
Kat mana saya nak letak ni? Letak kat, oh D selalunya hujung sini. Kan E awal tahun kan? Awal tahun kita write off, kita incorporate. Sampai hujung tahun mesti we must depreciate. Ha, tapi kan dia jatuh kat sini pula. Kita letak kat bawah ni lah. Alright, saya letak sini dah. Ini adalah untuk D. Dah. Okay. So, macam mana kelas untuk D? Debit apa?
Depreciation.
Okay.
Depreciation.
Okay, debit depreciation. Berapa kelas? Berapa? How much will be the depreciation currently?
2,000, madam.
Macam mana dapat formula? You guna formula apa? Ataupun buat the calculation tak boleh?
Divide by 10.
You ambil berapa? Macam mana kita nak depreciate untuk machine pada tahun 2017? Is it the same as the previous depreciation 50,000?
No.
Okay, revaluation. Yes, exactly. So yang betul new revalue, new value which is 450,000 divided by
10 years.
The remaining is full life. How much is the remaining is full life?
Eight.
So you have 10 gone with the 2 years. So you have to divide by 8. Very good. Very good. So now, how much is the depreciation there?
56,250.
Yes, 56,250. So that will be new depreciation charge. So you are doing your D kan? So what is the double entry for D actually? After D?
Credit accumulated depreciation.
Very good. Yeah, okay. Ibu je. Saya tak nak space. Okay, credit dia. Accumulated depreciation. Betul? Yeah? Okay, so the same amount 5,625. Oh, so alright. So you already covered D, kan? Next, what you need to do for Ida? What is left?
Amortize.
Amortization. What is the double entry for amortization?
Debit ARR credit.
Debit ARR credit.
Sopor. Amortization.
Sopor. Amortization sent to Sopor. So how much? How do we get amortization from which figure? How is the formula?
Tanya, dia bukan revalue every 2 years ke?
Yes, now we are talking about the transaction on 2016 dulu. Apa yang berlaku, kita kena tahu. The information must be there. Okay, now, so this is what happened on 2017, throughout the 20s. Sekejap. Kita ni tengah buat apa ni? kita buat EE berlaku awal tahun kan?
Sepatutnya dia darab 2 lah kan, yang accumulated depreciation dengan ARR tu. Kiranya kita kira sampai 2018, betul tak?
Tak. Saya rasa kita ni terlebih ni. Sebenarnya macam gini. Ya, pada akhir tahun kan, kenapa kita buat timeline? Pada akhir tahun 2016, betul? Kita ada buat revalue kan? So revalue tu adalah fair value daripada carrying value 400, kita nak 450. So end of the year, what happen? End of the year, actually we are doing E sahaja. You kena eliminate. Then you incorporate. Depreciation tak? Dah berlaku bila untuk new? Kita akan buat untuk year 70. Nampak tak kelas? So what is this? This is for year 17 lah. Betul lah kita letak dekat year 17. Transaction yang ni mesti pada year 16. Yeah? So transaction ini you bawa pada year 16. Dia berlaku kat year 16 ataupun hujung year 16. Boleh kelas? Dia berlaku dekat year 16. Bawa di year 16. Oh ni kita akan buat record pada year 16. Sampai hujung tahun year 16 kita buat E. Tetapi bila we move forward to the year 17, we must depreciate as usual because this is a tangible asset. So depreciate as usual. But we using the new value, so it's going to be dah lah. Depreciation is 56250 with the accumulated, and then again you have to complete your dah or AU, which is AR must be amortized by how much? AR must be amortized by how much lah? How do we amortize AR? How do we amortize AR to complete our EDA? So E is last year, DA is going to be the next year. So we are doing DA now. What is the value in order to amortize the AR? Kita ambil nilai ARR tu, yes exactly 50,000 divided by?
Eight.
Yes, must as you, same as you depreciate the asset. To divide by 8, so how much?
6,250.
Yes, 6,250. So you can counter check whether it is a correct value by actually this figure must be the differences between the new depreciation and the previous depreciation. The difference actually from 50 to 56 to 54 is 6 to 54. Sama-sama that's going to be your revenue to set off back. Yeah, ni kita kata kita kena set off. So this is going to post to what class? Kita akan post ke satu account kita bagi amortization. Yeah, amortization which actually post to support part of your revenue. Increase back your profit by 6 to 50. So that's why it's okay to choose any model because it won't affect the profit at all. Okay, so now this is done. So kita tahu this transaction or depreciation for the year 70 will be like this regard with the asset. So serentak dengan tu is also happen same thing to the year of 18, betul tak? Year of 18 mesti sama kan? Tak ada apa-apa. Year 18, kita continue, you move on. Yeah, so, dia mesti berlaku lagi depreciation. Mesti buat lagi dah tu, depreciation and amortization. But, end of the year 18, what happen end of the year 18? We are going to have a revaluation balik kan? Kita revalue, right? Betul tak? Kita ada new value lagi. Ha. Yeah, so, kita pergi sini. Kita ada revalue balik. Ya, ilang. Apa ni? Cuba kawan dengan cik elok-elok eh. Copy. Lihatlah. Saya buat je lah baru. Insert. Alright. So kita revalue. So how much is the value of the land at the end of the year, year 18 tu? Berapa revalue dia?
2.2 million.
So kita panggil fair value dia how much? 2.2 million.
Yes.
Okay. So kalau in this case ya kelas, apa patut kita buat dia punya double entry? Untuk kita incorporate land senang. Harga dia 2 million, dia tak ada depreciate, bla bla bla. So kita nak harga ni kita write down dia jadi expenses. Now, what happened from previous year which is recorded already at 1.9 becoming 2.2, what is this situation?
Surplus.
Yeah, so ini adalah surplus. Yeah, so surplus ni dia punya recording macam mana kelas? Debit apa, credit apa?
Debit land.
Yeah, so debit land. Alright. So you must your debit land. Alright. Okay, debit land berapa?
300,000.
Ha? Ulang. Berapa?
300,000 ke?
Kita nak compare yang mana? Kita nak compare 2 million kepada 2.2 ke 1.9 kepada 2.2? Anyone? 1.9 lah. That's why kita buat recording. Maknanya whatever in the books is 1.9. Now we just focus 1.9. So as time move on, now another 2 years is changing from 1.9 to 2.2. This one from 2 million to 1.9. This is 1.9 to 2.2 million. So you are going to compare these values. So that's actually we have surplus by how much? How much is surplus?
300,000.
It's a 300,000. And then the double entry will be next credit to what? Credit what for the double entry?
Retained profit.
Retained profit.
Yes, you are going to compensate back kan? Eh, kenapa dia macam ni? Dia tengtong ke apa ni? Saya SPD. Dah tu pun dia kelas. Mampu teruknya kelas ya. Saya ingat buat account student je boleh hang-hang ke huara. Komputer. Word pun boleh hang ke. Subhanallah. Di mana ni kelas? Okay. Oh. kesian kan buat account komputer pun boleh huara kelas. Alright. So, macam mana kita nak buat apa ni? LAN kita? Kelas? LAN kita?
Credit return profit.
Credit return profit how much?
100,000.
100,000. Why you choose 100,000? Why 100,000?
Write off
my
deficit.
Yes, you write off the previous deficit. Very good. I like this answer. That's what I want to hear. Then debit what? Then this is not enough to debit the land 300.
ARR.
So the rest then goes to the ARR. Good. Konok pula saya. Senang je ngajar you all. Betul ke you open jawapan tu? You tiru kat mana-mana jawapan ni kelas? Tu buat madam ni tak cik. Confident lah dengan kami madam. Kami ni pandai. tak, saya bangga sebenarnya. Okay. This is supposed to be recorded on 31 December kan? Betul? Betul tak kelas? This is what happened on 31 December. Year 18. There is a surplus. Very good. Okay, now we focus on... Pening lah saya. We focus on machine pula. So machine kita tahu. End of the year. Tapi ada kita ada revalue at this date kan? Kita ada revalue right? So, okay. Kita ada revalue. Ha? Kita buat revalue sambil ni. Upik. Dia berlaku. La ilah. Kenapa? Why you tak kawan dengan I? Upik. Sini that. Then kita paste. Satu. Revelation took place 31 December. The revelation also took place on 31st December year 18. Macam tu. Alah, panjang sangat pula. Alright. So, lepas tu, ada satu lagi dia revalue bila? Untuk mesin. Ni, sama tarikh ni. Ni dapat fair value dia. Ni fair value dia ialah 450,000 tadi tu. Okay. Lepas tu, ada satu lagi revelation untuk machinery bila? 31 December year 18. Ha, ambil kat sini. Okay. So dekat sini you have to find the the what class? The fair value dah. What is the fair value at this date? Anyone? What's the fair value?
300,000.
Yeah, the fair value will be 300,000, is it? I don't know. Look at it. Oh yeah. This one 300,000, right? So now what should be the transaction on the the transaction that we need to do for the year 31 December year 18. Siapa tahu transaction yang kita kena buat? Biar dia clear. Tak apa you buat walaupun you tak menjawab soalan, tapi this is for the sake of understand the whole picture. So the first thing what you need to do when we do the revaluation, anyone? Cepat-cepat, time's up already. Cepat-cepat sikit lagi. Dia biar
mana? Fair value.
Apa dia? Come on. The first thing. Ida lah. Dia tak jadi Ida lah saya rasa. Dia jadi E je tak? Sebab we revalue end of the year tu. The possession should be untuk da tu is going to be next year right? So you are going to do E only. So E is what?
Eliminate.
Eliminate. The double entry will be?
Debit?
Debit accumulated.
Yes, debit accumulated depreciation by how much? How much? What is the calculation? What is the figure? Hurry up, hurry up. What is the accumulated depreciation actually? How do we get, how do we calculate the accumulated depreciation? Anyone, anyone? Hurry up. Figure apa ni? Mana accumulated depreciation? Anyone? Zamir, senyap je Zamir. Berapa accumulated depreciation kita on 31st December? Year 18. How much?
The accumulated.
200.
Ah, mana you dapat form, mana you dapat figure tu Zamir? Apa kali apa? Zamir. Apa kali apa Zamir? Aisyah? Aisyah mana? Aisyah. Apa nama tadi? Hanis Aisyah. Aisyah Hanis ya? Ruzalia? Ah, senyap belaka dah. You all, are you there?
Ya, yeah, madam.
Ah, cepatlah nak cari accumulated depreciation untuk year 18. Apa maksudnya? Previous year depreciation dah berapa banyak dah? Mana figure kita ambil? Yes, mana dapat tu? Mana dapat figure tu? Tunjuk berapa kali berapa? Ambil figure apa kali apa? Betul, jawapan tu.
Darab 2.
Ah. Yes, yeah, so berapa apa darab 2? 5, 6 kan? 5, 6 to 50 ni, you kena kali? 2. Yeah, for 2 years. So how much is 2 years? 112, 500. Because this is only accumulated depreciation left. The previous one is eliminated already. So what is for the left is 112 remaining. So you're going to write off. So credit what? Credit what class?
Machine.
Ah, write off against the machine. Very good. Okay, write off against the machine. So it's going to go write down the machine. Yeah, so credit the machinery. How much? The same amount, 112. 112 berapa? 500 lah. 112, 500. Okay. So this one actually telling you that you are writing down, or first you eliminate the accumulated depreciation, then your machine is going down from the last value, which is 450, will be written down back by 112,500. So now your machine actually having a carrying value of what? Tarikh ni berapa carrying value you? Ha, kelas? Berapa carrying value kita sebenarnya? Kelas? Berapa carrying value kita?
337,500.
So mana dapat tu? Ni dapat carrying value ialah kita ambil daripada apa? 450,000 kan? Tolak dengan 112,500 tak? Ha. Ataupun 1, 2, 5K. Okay. So berapa kelas? Carrying value dia?
337,500.
337,500. Nah, it's specific. Yeah, okay now. So you have to reduce your write-off. So now, you, okay, this is, kita buat apa ni? Kita buat E kan? E, we must eliminate. And next, we have to incorporate. So how do we incorporate?
Debit machine.
Yes, have debit machine. So actually from the comparison, you know that you are having what? The fair value is 300. The carrying value is 337. What happened actually?
Deficit.
Oh, kalau deficit kena debit machine ke? Deficit. Deficit debit machine ke kan? Yes, yeah, you kena credit machine kan? Kenapa? So can we tell kita 337, sekarang we want it to be 300, so we have to write down the machine. So write machine will be credit to reduce the machine. So how much you have to credit the machine? How much plus? So from 337, you want it to be 300. So how much? You simply minus
5,000
minus 1,000 minus 300 kan? Minus 300,000. So how much will be the written down value?
37,500.
37.5 37,500. Alright, so now debit what? That's the main question. What you need to debit? Us. Kita nak debit apa kalau berlaku if it happen to be deficit? The general rule apa dia kelas? Debit what? The general rule. Class?
ARR.
Yes, normally we have to debit support our expenses right in the name of deficit. But then you look at the previous. Previous year kita ada surplus tak? Surplus tak kat sini?
Yeah.
Ada kan ni nama dia ARR ni. ARR ni surplus. Kejap-kejap ARR ni. ARR kita 50,000. Tapi kelas, you make sure that your 50,000 is having enough tau. So kalau kita tengok sini ARR asalnya dia berlaku pada ni year 16 ni ARR you ada 50,000 betul? Lepas tu ARR you have to be reduced by 6254 for 2 years. Ni gone by 6254, 6254. So sebenarnya ARR you berapa remaining balance? Berapa remaining balance of ARR lepas you write off ni? Berapa remaining balance you? Boleh tu you check dulu. Berapa remaining balance dalam ARR? Berapa ARR? Remaining ARR selepas you write off. Apa remaining ARR class?
43,750.
Mana you dapat? You ambil daripada 50,000 tadi kan? You kena minus apa you dah amortize tadi. 6254. So tolak dengan 6254 multiply by 2 sebab you buat 2 years. 6254 multiply by 2 sebab you buat 2 years. So berapa jawapan ni kelas? What is the remaining balance of ARR from beginning kita ada
500.
Tak dengar. 37,500,000. Okay, so sekarang you nak reducekan you punya machine by 37,500, and then definitely you akan guna apa? ARR, sebab ARR ada lagi. Understand? There's still balance in ARR. Fully utilize your ARR. So how much will be 37,500,000. Macam tu. Kejap pakai K, kejap kan pakai ni. Tak boleh lah. Alright, clear tak kelas? Dapat the clear picture. So we are doing post-mortem actually. We are doing the post-mortem of the question. Then we have to ask, what the question one? Soalan apa you all? Anyone? Soalan apa ni?
Accounting
treatment.
Accounting treatment kan. Macam mana saya nak buat lari pula. Ram betul lah sayang. Okay. So, pergi jalan sikit. Tengok ya. Apa soalan apa? Soalan nak accounting treatment. So, what is the accounting treatment of the land on 34 December? Senanglah kita dah ada dah ni kelas. Kita dah ada dah. Accounting treatment on 34 December for the land. So, macam ni kita nak jawab? So, sama-sama. Actually, you should explain back the journal entry. So, what happened on 34 December for the land? What happened? Kelas.
Tak salah kita jawab nombor satu. Okay, nombor satu. Accounting treatment. So macam mana kita nak jaga accounting treatment tu kelas? Kelas. Cepat-cepat accounting treatment kita nak jaga apa? Sikit je tu.
Alamak, masa dah habis. Okay kelas my advice is you all tengok balik yang tolong jawab soalan ya. Sebab kita buat post-mortem aja soalan tu. So, semua jawapan ada kat sini. Semua keluar dalam bentuk sentence saja. Accounting treatment untuk machine semua ada. Dah ada dalam journal dah ada. So, calculation kita dah buat. Semua dah ada calculation. So, you just follow what the question one and then buat the journal entry. Boleh kelas? Kelas, can you do that?
Boleh, madam.
Alright, so you complete kan answering the question ni kelas. Kalau dalam written book ya, kalau you bagi macam ni pun dah banyak markah saya bagi sebenarnya. You bagi saya bentuk talian macam ni pun, as long as I understand, I can give you marks already. Tapi, why not kita answer the question? Boleh? Alright? So, I have to go. So, I have to go macam saya nak kena berangkat. I have to ask other group lah. Alright. Boleh? Alright. So, please complete your exercise.
Yeah, madam.
Alright. Thank you. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Alright.
Thank you, madam.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Alright.